Via the video printer, we have reporters in press boxes up and down the country with Gavin Peacock, Carlton Palmer, Garth Crooks and Steve McMahon here in the Score Interactive studio. We can confirm all the latest scores in all today's football matches. But first up, let's just find out exactly what has been going throughout the day. The game that's already over, the story of the Southampton-Manchester City game, comes from Martin Fisher.
James Beattie could be out of action for up to 6 weeks after being taken to hospital with a suspected broken toe. But in the press conference after this extraordinary game, Steve Wigley, whose future could still be in doubt as manager because of a coaching qualification technicality, says he's still enjoying the job. City overwhelmed Southampton in the first half. Distan and two other efforts from Richard Dunn were all cleared off the line, while Sungjae High and John Macken squandered golden opportunities. But Southampton never gave up. McCann and Phillips should have done better. And David James pulled off a marvellous save 5 minutes from time from Peter Crouch.
League leaders Arsenal 47 unbeaten at home to 7th place Charlton this afternoon. Ivan Gasker with the story of the game so far.
And the round of applause tells you that the locals hereabouts are well satisfied with what they've seen. Arsenal ahead, and they deserve to be. Hard to see how Charlton can turn this one around, really. They failed to muster a single meaningful shot. Arsenal ahead after Dennis Bergkamp supplied the cross for Freddie Ljungberg to finish have had a stack of chances. Only Dean Kiley, who's on keeping clean sheets for charity duty today. I'm afraid that's not going to happen for him. But it really isn't hard to see why Arsenal are top of the league and unbeaten in 47. The half century is looming large. Tonight it should be 48.
And Gavin Peacock's watching that game for us this afternoon. Arsenal in control?
Arsenal in control, playing some good stuff. Charlton have come out with a team shape and a team plan, but Arsenal are just too good for them. One thing, just at the end, right on half-time, Charlton had a free kick and they've whipped it in there. Horizon's almost got there because Lehmann came out flapping again. And that is the one weak link in the Arsenal side, if you ask me.
Well, it's all gone off.
What's happening there, Carlton?
It's all gone off going down the tunnel.
That's at Goodison Park, yeah?
Yeah, well, I should think one or two of the Tottenham players should be looking to have a fight up because they've totally been outclassed. Something's happened there. I don't know if somebody's given a tuba clip on the way through the tunnel, but it's all gone off down there.
Well, Everton against Tottenham this afternoon. Everton started the season 1-5, drawn 1, lost 1. Tottenham lost 1 of 7. Let's just get Damien Johnson's verdict of the game so far.
Yeah, as they shuffle off down the tunnel, Everton will be disappointed not to go in leading. They set out their stall early and dominated, but just lacked the cutting edge to put them ahead. Tim Cahill and Leon Osman and Kevin Kilbane as well all went close as Everton showed real desire. They snapped into the tackles when they lost possession. Marcus Bent, a lone front runner. We may see Duncan Ferguson and James McFadden in the second half.
Well, at Goodison Park, and here we go, just as they're going off the pitch there, that is a little bit of a skirmish, and then it's started to develop there. What's your reading of that, Steve McMahon?
Well, frustration, obviously. I mean, from both sets of players, but by what's going on, Everton are playing really well. Tottenham are getting very frustrated. And handbags, you can see the two of them are fluffing about with each other. Get in the dressing room and get themselves sorted out.
Carlton, Jamie Redknapp being the peacemaker there, it looks like.
Yeah, I mean, I thought it was maybe with the Everton, but it seems with his own teammates. But to be honest with you, they should be getting annoyed at one another because, let me tell you, Everton have totally outplayed them, outfought them. I mean, I've got the stats here. 8 attempts they've had on goal. Paul Robinson making 2 outstanding saves, 6 corners and 1 attempt for Tottenham.
It's not unusual, is it, when it's nil-nil and there's nothing between the two teams, for someone to try and cause a little bit of a spark, to get the crowd going, everybody going. Especially, and it's not unusual for something to happen in the tunnel because... And Spurs have responded. They're doing all right. They've got nil-nil and they can come out... And
maybe that's just something about Spurs this season. You know, a little bit more fight in the belly, you know? Yeah. And they've been outplayed in that first half and maybe see a reaction second half.
Aston Villa, Andrew James with all the details.
Two good goals, two good examples of the merits of incisive passing, Ray, as well. Somewhat against the run of play, Villas de la Cruz dispatched a super pass, allowing Angel to score with a diagonal shot beyond Friedel. But moments later, Dickoff's run to the byline and subsequent cross from the most acute of angles was tapped in on the line by Rovers unmarked skipper Barry Ferguson.
Norwich Portsmouth now. Dominic Cotton with all the latest here.
Well, both sides started with hope here on form. This was a difficult game to call. After 10 minutes, Leon McKenzie came close to putting the hosts in front, his header shaving the upright. Portsmouth new boy Diamante Kamara then wasted a string of chances before Nigel Kwashi hit one from distance. Rob Green beat it away and Aig Beni Yakubu picked up the rebound before nipping round the Norwich defence to fire home. Norwich have yet another uphill struggle on their hands.
Steve McMahon, your verdict?
Yeah, it's a fairly even game, but Portsmouth look more likely to score goals. I mean, the two strikers look very, very sharp. I'm impressed with Yakubu and Kamara, and they deservedly win 1-0, only just though.
Garth, what's your theory on the game you're watching so far?
Good tempo between Blackburn and Villa. Angel looking sharp, gets the first goal for Villa. One-touch finish. I thought it was a two-touch, it was a one-touch finish. And the equaliser, terrific 1-2 by Dickoff and Ferguson.
Thanks, Garth. Just before the second half of all today's matches gets going, there's a cartoon version of David Beckham featured in a new advert just being released. Let's take a look at that. And also, we've got a compilation of other footballers that have been in adverts down the years.
Nice work, Scoop. So, like, who really is the ghoul?
David Beckham!
How could Scooby tackle David? That's impossible.
Jinkies, because he's not the real David Beckham.
Scooby?
So who's...
David Beckham!
I was only trying to teach an old dog new tricks.
This is Jimmy Hill, Fulham's famous bearded inside right, shaving his beard off with the new Remington.
Oba, oba, oba.
Do I not like orange?
Oh, that's nice. Good luck from Bobby and Grant.
Stanley Matthews will tell you that good footwork needs good footwork.
Many more footballers involved in adverts coming and scoring active later. Anyone going to admit to being in an advert down the years?
No, I haven't been in one. I'm thinking about the old head there, that's shaving the head.
My claim to fame is Cracker Jack.
You've been on Cracker Jack?
Cracker Jack.
You've been on Cracker Jack too, haven't you?
Yep.
I'm waiting for the...
We're the only two old enough.
Stunt. I was dipping my head in cornflakes and everything.
So, Cracker Jack?
Cracker Jack.
Cracker Jack. Still to come on Score Interactive, some Bill Shankly magic from the archives, but also be concentrating on bringing you news of all the second half goals as they go in. Digital viewers can access Score Interactive by pressing the red button on the digital remote control. On a Freeview box, it's channel 701. But now it's the snooker for the Grand Prix, where Ronnie O'Sullivan is hoping the new season picks up where it left off. Just over 20 minutes to go in this afternoon's football matches. Plenty of time for scorelines to change. We have 20 reporters ready to bring news of equalising or winning goals. The video prints will confirm news of goals elsewhere. Gavin Peacock, Carlton Palmer, Garth Crooks and Steve McMahon are keeping a close eye on this afternoon's four Premiership matches. Let's quickly find out the story in all those games. Just to confirm, at lunchtime it was Southampton 0, Manchester City 0. But Arsenal, the champions, unbeaten in 47. Goal scoring for fun so far this season. They only got one last week. They've put that right this week. They're at home to Charlton in seventh place. Ivan Gaskell.
Well, it's absolutely chucking it down here at Arsenal, and Charlton must feel like chucking the towel in. Really, the referee should step in and stop it to prevent them from taking further punishment. It's been that easy. Two goals in the last couple of minutes. Absolutely fantastic strikes, both of them. Thierry Henry, first of all, exchanging passes with Reyes, as Gavin mentioned. And then a fantastic strike from Reyes himself. He really is a special player too. All the plaudits will go to Henry's fantastic goals. Two very different strikes that you'll see on Match of the Day tonight. Set the video, whatever you do. But 4-0, and it's going to be Arsenal at a canter.
Norwich against Portsmouth in the Premiership. Let's get the story of the game so far from Dominic Cotton. Sounds like it's a cracker.
This is an absolute belter, and we've just had the crossbar rattled by Gary Holt, who's attempting to put Norwich in front. Ike Benny Yakubu scored first for Portsmouth, that in the first half. Then Darren Huckabee brought Carrow Road to life with a retaken penalty to bring it to 1-1. Patrick Berger then fired Portsmouth back in front with a 25-yard free kick before a Simon Charlton header restored parity. It's 2-2 here, and the home fans are having a pretty good time of it.
goals to in the Blackburn Aston Villa game for Andrew James to tell us about.
Yes, Blackburn 2, Villa 1. That after Villa went in front through Rampablo Angel. Ferguson got one back, and then the Australian Brett Emerton beating Sorensen at his near post after a great ball forward from Djorkaeff. Djorkaeff, a surprise debutant today. We thought he'd start on the bench, but he got into the starting lineup. He's now been substituted by John Stead and got a standing ovation when he went off. Blackburn getting their way on top.
To Goodison Park, Everton against Tottenham. Damian Johnson, this is fiery.
Certainly is. Everton have dominated the game, but trail. Noah Pamaro's second half header against the run of play put Spurs ahead. But really, the visitors should be down to nine men. That's the talking point at the moment. Jamie Redknapp received only a yellow card for a disgraceful challenge. He went over the ball on Tim Cahill's shin. Redknapp attempted an apology, but it was waved away by Cahill, who limped off. And then a disgraceful two-footed challenge by Jermaine Defoe on David Weir also received only a caution. Everton pressing for an equaliser. Duncan Ferguson is on, but they're rightly aggrieved.
Colin Palmer's watching that match at Goodison Park. It's out of character, but is Jamie Redknapp guilty of a bad challenge there?
I mean, like you say, I know Jamie very, very well, but I mean, you know, he's saying that he's gone to Cahill to say he didn't intend to do it, but I'll tell you now, his eyes, he's way, way over the top of the ball. He's caught him, like, just below the top of the knee. It's a three...
Career threatening.
That's the one. Yeah. It's a bad tackle.
Get your worms out.
But then Defoe, on the touchline there, on where, two-footed, jumping in tackle right in front of the linesman, and he's not even booked.
Yeah, are Everton going to get back in this game?
I don't know. They've gone right. They're still dominating the game. They've got Ferguson on there, and they just can't seem to work the ball wide to get any crosses in. I don't know. It's looking like Tottenham might just nick this. There'll be uproar if they do.
Boston United 1, Scunthorpe 1. Scunthorpe second in the table in Coca-Cola 2. Gavin Peacock, are you watching Masters at work today with Arsenal?
I am watching such a display of skill, pace, and quality. It's unbelievable. This side, you just can't see them losing at the moment. They're playing within themselves as well, Stubbsy. I mean, Charlton are not an easy prospect, you know, and they came and they were dogged to start with. But Arsenal's just got an answer for everything because of the variation in their play as well, because of the movement and the skill, and they've got the maestro up front in Henry.
Wickham started well but are falling away. Their home form has been letting them down. 4 wins from the first six, only one from the last four, and they have more points away from home than they're getting at home. And they equalised though against Shrewsbury through Danny Sender on 74 minutes. Wickham hoping to get more than just 1 point out of that game. Garth Crooks, you're watching Blackburn against Aston Villa. And in the first half, you're saying Yuri Djorkaeff was the master. Is he proving to be the difference between the teams?
Well, it's his first game today, and he's just been brought off. He's been replaced.
Well, he's not then,
by
is he?
Flitcraft, but he has been outstanding today. Make no mistake, good game, good contest. For Blackburn, I put a star by Dickoff's name because he has terrorised Melberg. Barry Ferguson's had a captain's performance. Carlton, Cole and Angel have played well for Villa up front, but Cole has been very unlucky from the goal. He could have had two goals today, which would have sealed the game for Villa. But Villa are fighting like bears. They really are. And they're not out of this game by a long chalk.
Aston Villa, sort of no away win. Sort of they were hoping to put that right today. Steve, you're watching the Norwich-Portsmouth game, and sort of it's difficult to see which way this is going to go, isn't it?
It's a great game, it really is. I mean, Norwich can find themselves unfortunate not to be 4-2 ahead. I mean that. The young lad, Gary Holt, has had a great impact. He's had a fantastic effort from 25 yards, half volley. You talk about hitting the ball.